Coming to you from Keiko Studios, it's The Balcony Show with Ann Thatcher, Bo Summer, Mike Roy, Donna DeLucci, and me, the Mad Cat. We have searched the globe for the best in indie music so you don't have to. So here we go, The Balcony Show.
All friends in faraway places, sent with love and good vibes. Just keep an eye out for just what's coming.
Hi, everybody. You're listening to The Balcony Show.
It is The Balcony Show.
It is The Balcony. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hi. God, I feel like a stranger.
I know.
You should.
I'm sorry.
Praise all holy spiritual thing. This election is over, and that's all I'm going to say.
Bye-bye.
I'm happy that I'm all day long for the past freaking 3 weeks.
My phone. The texting.
And I'm like, you know, yeah, I'm like, oh, yay, Mad Cat's popular again. No. It's every shoebox freaking texter. And then they started calling me.
What are you calling me? A shoebox texter?
Shoebox. No. They are.
Because it's just like, you know.
Oh, all the spam. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
It just didn't stop. You know, they were getting like really invasive.
2 a.m, I'm still getting them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
That's
not right, though,
because that's such an invasive.
That doesn't help your cause. That hurts your cause.
And I'm not going to open your. In this day and age, with all the spam and the viruses
and how many
malware,
who knows?
Are we going to really start clicking on links?
But anyways, congratulations to Donald Trump for his win, and here we come, 2020.
I'm going to run in 2028, just so you know.
I'll vote for you.
I figure, you know what, Harambe.
I'm going to write you in.
Harambe, a dead gorilla, and the phrase "these nuts" polled really well in 2016. Like, unnervingly well.
I did not know that.
Yeah, it was crazy. Like, everybody's like, this is really
hilarious.
Ridiculous.
I did not know that.
So I'm like, you know.
That's fun.
Well, the only thing that I got to say is, people, if you want change, you have to get out there and make the change happen. And it's got to start at your local.
Yes. Bo and I have said it really does.
A lot of stuff needs to move back to the county and state levels. Yes.
Teach your children.
Right. Whenever you look and you see on TV, when they have like a state thing or a county thing going on, you don't see anybody there.
No.
And that's part of the problem. That's not the way this machine is.
Well, that's why we don't know. Most of us don't really know what's going on. We don't know the bills that are being put into the legislature. We don't. Nope. I mean, if I couldn't name 10, if somebody asked me right now, I could not name 10 bills that were submitted.
But if you go on the websites and actually read through the bills that are on the table for your state representatives and senators, that's who you need to care about. You can't just wait for the president.
Well, true.
But if you read the legalese of laws, it's not like this simple, like the rhetoric craziness that we see on TV and we just get inundated with.
Well, it depends on where the bill is introduced, because you're right. If it's introduced,
the meat of it, most people don't seek out and read.
If it's introduced in the states, then that's a whole different process before it even gets into the federal government. But the federal government, that's a whole nother animal. And I'm just going to be thankful that I have a home, going to be thankful that I have health care, and I'm moving on from there. That's all I got to say about that.
I'd also like to give a shout out to the passing of Peanut the Squirrel.
I can't.
In an absolute.
The raccoon.
Yeah. And what was his?
Rocky, wasn't it?
I think it was Fred. Fred the raccoon.
What are we doing?
You know.
I don't know what we're doing.
All because a lady, she's a photographer of like an environmental photographer out in Texas. And she flapped her gums. And that was enough for the DEC of New York to give this man no due process whatsoever.
Yeah.
I'm going to say this, and with all my heart, stay in your lane.
Word.
Period. Stay in your own lane.
Yeah.
I am so sick. I am
so much out there.
Sick of people. Don't you know what I mean? Like, don't you get to tell me what to say how to talk. You don't get to tell me what words. You know what? If I say something, I suffer the consequences of whatever it is that I say. Amen. But otherwise, I'm an adult. Stay in your lane.
Can we get a preach it, Ann? A three. I can't. My shoulder hurts. I give it a three snaps.
You know what I mean? I'm like, I've had enough. I've had enough. So anyways, but I got a thatch tag, believe it or not.
Tell us.
And thatch tag, Highway Parade Marshal.
Highway Parade Marshal.
At the first ever Highway Parade Marshal. Want to know how I managed to do that?
Please tell us.
Of course.
Please tell our listeners.
So my daughter's car, I had her car, and it started smoking like crazy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, tell us where you were.
I was down in West Easton, which is about 10 miles from where I'm at, where I live.
So daytime, nighttime?
It was dusk. I went to pick up my husband from work. So we were there, and boy, that thing was smoking. Anyway, so we called on, I have OnStar, and I got to give OnStar a shout out. Wow, they were there within 10 minutes.
Wow.
I have never had a tow truck show up so quickly and be so... so nice, but here's the spin. The tow truck was one of those flatbeds, and it was really high. Yeah. And as you know, you guys know, I'm having issues with my back and my knees lately. I couldn't climb up into that. So, yes, he did load me in the car on top of the flatbed.
Yeah.
And I have a picture of myself.
No, you didn't.
I have a picture of the look of me. Out looking the over the
my God. And
that, so I'm waving at people going down the highway because you know what? That's me. So first ever highway parade marshal. I'm just saying.
He left you ride in the back of the car on the rollback.
Yeah, I know you're not supposed to do that, but yeah. And I want to tell you, that was one heck of a bumpy ride.
Oh, I had no idea.
Well, you gotta consider the shocks that normally would protect you on your car. Your car is strapped down to the bed of that truck.
I mean,
so you got no cushion no
more. I mean, holy Hannah. You know what I mean? Like it was a really rough ride. That's funny. He took his time and
I would wet myself to be happen to be driving down the highway that day and see Ann on the with her car in the back of a rollback and her head sticking out the window.
So yeah, that was me. If you saw me,
could we please see a picture of that?
I'll show you. Yeah.
All right.
But there's not actually a picture of me though. It's a picture I took of your view from.
Oh my God.
But yeah, that was me. So if you saw me there and I was waving at you and you know and doing the salute, yeah. So first ever highway parade marshal. I don't recommend it. Anyways, on tonight's show we have a local. Kind of local group. They're about an hour from here. And they were on the show several years ago. They have a new single. So we're bringing them back. Their name is Springbrooke and they are absolutely phenomenal.
Oh,
if you
so
are
good.
Into, what do you consider this Mad Cat? Kind of like a...
It would be that, you know, it's so weird. The way the genres are just getting so muddy.
I'd say it's rock. I'd say it's definitely rock. But
it is rock. But
with Americana.
Yeah, with like a slight folk edge to it.
Ooh, but edge.
Know? Yeah.
Definitely
yeah.
Like a raunchy, edgy.
Yeah, like it's just all there.
And so if you ever get the chance to see these guys live out here, the name of the band is Springbrooke. You're definitely going to want to catch them because Bo and I caught them one time and they just put on a hell of a show. They were phenomenal. So
they were very memorable. We saw them one time and they made such a huge impression.
So Chris and Ryan, they will be up with us shortly. But first, we're going to get things started with a song by Josh Gallagher, Bar Fools. So take a listen, and we'll be right back.
We know a lot of those.
They got high-rise clubs slinging high-priced custom spirits in a highball glass. And pretentious pubs that pretend the suds are better cause it's micro mass. And cigar, sky.
Scotch only bars, ones where you charge your drinks to your room card. But if you need to find me, I'll be sitting in a dive seat. Cause I'm a magic to the magic of a hole in the wall, where the neon flickers in the cigarette smoke, where the dance floor in the dark board seem as a fall. From first drink nights and last call fights and rednecks pickled on dingle rye, where the Yelp review and attitude is a 2.23. Where the bar stools are full of bar fools like me. Us fools of a feather, yet we flock together. We're cut from the same old cloth. The color of your collar or the number of dollars in your bank don't matter at all. You're my kind. If your drinking vibe is under Christmas lights and cheap ceiling tiles, so pull up a seat, the first one's on me. If you're a magic to the magic of a hole in the wall, where the neon flickers in the cigarette smoke, where the dance floor in the dark board of seamless share of balls. From first drink nights and last call fights and rednecks pickled on, where the Yelp review and attitude is a 2.23. Where the bar stools are full of bar fools like me. Yeah, I love them squeaky red swivel seats full of Friday folks like me. To the magic of a hole in the wall, where the neon flickers in the cigarette smoke, where the dance floor in the dark board have seen their share of falls. From first drink nights and last call fights and rednecks pickled on dingle rye, where the Yelp review and attitude is a 2.23. Where the bar stools are full of bar fools like me.
Hey, folks, welcome back to the Balcony Show. Right now, we have the first song from tonight's interview with Ryan from the band Springbrooke. The song is called Blood Moon by Springbrooke. Give it a listen. When you come back, we're going to have Ryan right here in the studio
live
with us.
I gotta get it any way I can.
Oh, let's go out riding, mama. Let's go cruise and eat the crimson moon.
Let's go out riding, baby. Go out cruise and eat the crimson moon.
Cause I've been itching for my fix, girl. I gotta get it real, real soon.
Well, there's a black.
See the feeling I'm inside you. Now I wanna see you bear your teeth.
Everybody, welcome to the Balcony Show. We're very happy to have Ryan from Springbrooke here. They are a band out of, you got to say it, Ryan, because
Bucks County, Warrington.
They were nominated for Best Award in Bucks County. And if I have to say that Bo and I watched this band play, Ryan's band play, and they put on one. It was like you were the highlight of our day that day.
Oh, we were blown away.
Absolutely blown away.
Dude, you were like, you were so memorable. Like, you were not playing this backyard function.
Yeah, no.
Even though it was like a big deal. Like,
it was a big deal, but it was still. Yeah, no, you stood out.
Thank you very much. Yeah,
put on a show.
So. You have a new single out, and we're going to talk about the single upcoming. But you also put out an album, Tried and True, which is absolutely on my playlist. Absolutely one of my favorite albums of one of the best, actually, that's been on the Balcony Show for me in the local environment, definitely. But we just heard the song Blood Moon. How did you come about your sound, Ryan? Why did you choose, and how would you define it?
I like to call it roots rock and roll. You know, it's a fair mix of roots music.
Better expression than what we came up with.
Yeah, like,
we're kind of leaning around like a rockish folk almost, you know, but we couldn't nail the dot. You gave us the dot.
Yep.
That's it, dude.
And you know what? I'm going to write that down. Roots.
Roots rock.
Yeah. Roots rock.
With an edge, raw.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I mean, I'd say where it comes from is just from growing up. I mean, you know, nobody that I know listens to only one type of music, you know? So some of the earliest stuff I listened to was Elvis Presley, Gene Autry. And I'm talking about, you know, before I could freaking walk, like, you know, for as long as I can remember. That's what my old man would be playing, you know? He's got a video of me walking back and forth on one of those broomstick horses with the cowboy hat on, and Back in the Saddle by Gene Autry's playing in the background.
Oh,
and
my goodness.
I'm trying to sing along with it, you know, and Elvis Presley, you know, was, you know, my first
the king.
Favorite.
Oh, Come on, the king.
Beat him. You know, guy was chiseled out of gold, man.
And I do want to say the one thing that I really, really like about your music, and specifically you as a singer, you have this, you have this ability to really bring the music in. You know what I mean? Like, it's, for lack of a better word, I'd say tight, and please don't mistake that as a, you know what I mean?
But no.
But it's on point. And I so appreciate that, because there's a lot of musicians out there that just can't quite get it there. Mm-hmm. And you you get it there and you raise the bar on it. So I really appreciate that, Ryan. It's so clear and you're just, you know, it's phenomenal. And you have this new song, Cold War. Where did that come from?
Where that song kind of comes from, the lyrics come from me, is a frustration of, you know, not really being able to find the truth about anything. You know, I think we have a lot of problems today with the media, you know, that's out there. The one line that really sticks with me is, you know, we're all going to fall silent if we can't come together. You know, we should all be able to express our ideas regardless of, you know, what you feel and what your values are.
Yeah.
But we should be able to have a straight conversation.
Well, I mean, I think we've learned we don't hold space for people anymore. You know what I mean? Like a lot of people just listen to talk. Mm-hmm. They're not hearing. Yep. What they're doing is they're waiting their turn to interject their agenda.
Yeah.
So let's take a break and we're going to listen to Cold World by Springbrooke. You're going to want this one, folks. I guarantee it. We'll be right back with Ryan.
Fight!
Hey, folks, welcome back to the Balcony Show. We are on the, well, not even on the line. The dude's sitting right across from me.
Oh, boom.
I guess the 80-degree heat in November is getting to the Mad Cat's brain, but we are sitting right here with Ryan from Springbrooke. Ryan, this is the part of the show where I ask the really, really hard questions.
All right, then.
Okay.
Buckle up.
We got to really get down to earth here. Where are you playing, bro?
We got a couple more shows coming up. December 6th, we're going to be at the Eddington House. It's one of our favorite spots in Bent Salem. We usually get a pretty solid crowd out there. Nice. So that'll be a 4-hour show. And you know, if those of you who have not heard of our band before, we're an original group. Like we said earlier on the show, we're out of Bucks County, and we've been building our set for a long time. We could probably just about play it with our eyes closed, and we bring a lot of energy to it. So we do a lot of covers, but we like to throw our own spin on them. So a lot of them are going to have more like rock and roll kind of, you know, gritty feel, or sometimes we just keep it classic, you know, but, we'll keep you guessing, you know, you'll
for sure.
You'll like what you're hearing.
That's what's up.
Yeah. And when we mix our album in there, we got an album out. It's called Tried and True. Damn good album. We usually play most of the songs on that album too. You know, I guarantee you'll like them.
And there isn't a bad one on there, really.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And it's all free, man. You get it on Spotify, was it Apple Music, all that good stuff. Yeah. So, if you want to see where we're playing, so you can go on Springbrooke. What the hell is it? I'm sorry. Yeah. So you got to type in Springbrooke with an E at the end of it, musicpa.com. So that's all strung together. SpringbrookeMusicPA.com, and you can see our whole show schedule on there. But
and you definitely, if you are in any range, you definitely want to do two things. You want to go see this band, and you definitely want their music. Mm-hmm. I guarantee it. If this is your genre, and even if it's not, you know what I mean?
I was a fan. I became a fan after seeing you guys live. Yes.
That's another thing that I like about this band too, is that Springbrooke is Springbrooke music. Mm-hmm. You're not like, there's a lot of bands that are trying to be somebody else.
Yeah.
You can speak to that, Mike Roy. You know what I'm talking about.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about bands that aren't doing their own thing. They're trying to be somebody else.
Those bands. Yes, there's a lot of that.
Yeah, we don't copy anybody. You know, I mean, we get down there, we write what we write, you know, we all love all different kinds of music. And, you know, I mean, we got stuff that sounds like, you know, you could line it up next to Hank Williams Sr. We also got stuff that's, you know, getting a little more into the heavier, like metal side of things, you know, because we've all played in those kind of different bands, you know, it's all different emotions,
works.
Man, and everybody's got it.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to end things tonight. Okay. This video. Ryan, I had several of my lady friends who are a lot younger than me, but even some of the older ones, end of the line.
It's a good one.
So Ryan is in a wife beater. Let me just say that. The song is Hotter Than Hell.
Thank you very much.
And it's incredible. It's absolutely incredible. And If there was anything that you ever needed to make your day at the end of the day, end of the line, how?
Well, it's about feeling stuck, you know, to put it, you know, in so many words. So that song kind of came out of, I did not go to college. I went to Bucks County Community College for a hot cup of coffee. I really didn't have, that many skills that I'd learned by the time I graduated high school. And I had a pretty naive, you know, perspective about, you know, what the working world would be like. I went right into construction, and I loved my first job. You know, I was getting paid $15 an hour. I was working at this salt yard right on the Delaware River. I won't beat your ears off about that, but I loved it, man. I mean, I couldn't get enough of it. You know, the trucks and the hoppers and the giant barges coming up from Chile and South America. And we would offload these boats, and we do it in the middle of the night. I worked for a great guy. He's still near and dear to my heart. And the guy that gave me the job, his boss, he passed away. God rest in peace. Yeah, it was Gus Proper. And yeah, I fell in love with that job, but I had it in my head that, you know, and I'd had it beaten into my head that if I didn't go to college, then I'd, you know, never become anything good. And so I left that job to go to Bucks County Community College, and that really didn't work out because it was just like, this sucks.
The coffee wasn't no good.
I could go on and on about it, but you know, basically for what I wanted to go to school for, I had to take all four of their art classes, and they were from 8 in the morning to 12, and I got another job at a warehouse. I was working 5 in the afternoon to 2 in the morning, so there was not really a lot of time to get sleep, and it just didn't make sense to me. You know, it was too much money for, you know, not really, you know, a clear goal. I'll never understand why it costs so much to go to college and get books and all that crap.
Nobody understands.
You know? Or why they force you to take other stuff that is of no interest to you.
Yeah.
Sometimes even no value. Right. You know what I mean?
And that's the thing. Like, you know, if you have a specific thing that you want to target, that you want to do,
yeah,
but then they pile on this other stuff that they make mandatory that you need to be present for. And it's like,
it's a freaking racket.
Yeah.
Man.
It's like, yeah.
It's all about money.
This is the thing I want to learn about.
God help these kids that try and go to school and make something out of themselves, and then they can't find a job in their major. They got that debt hanging over their head, man. Forget about it.
Or technology. I get it. But even technology, you can get certifications now.
It's insane. Yeah. But I will say this. I'm so glad that you were feeling that way, because there would not be that video for everybody out there.
Yeah, here we go.
People like me, people like Bo, people like, for all of us who enjoy a really good video and a really good song. I think everybody can identify with End of the Line. I think we've all been there at one time where we felt like, this is it.
I live there perpetually.
You know what I mean? Like, it's not just about maybe... It's good to hear your interpretation, but I could see where a lot of people could say, I've just had enough. You know what I mean?
Like, there's a lot more that could be said, but it would take a long time to say.
Right. So the video, check it out. And I want to thank you, Ryan, for coming here, spending some time with us on the show, and check out the video for End of the Line. This is a song you're definitely also going to want. The whole album, Tried and True, get it. Get the new song, Cold World. And any final shout-outs to anybody?
No, not particularly. I just want to thank you guys for having me up here and having me on. Thank you.
All right, Ryan. So everybody take a listen to End of the Line. Check the video out, ladies.
Oh, we will. Again.
By Springbrooke. And we'll be right back with the rest of the show.
A bright kid, they said. Yeah, I was young, headstrong back then. I had these ideas and visions of where I thought this path would lead. How easily that carried me, and I followed my ambitions. I was driven, so I tried, but I guess I stopped dreaming somewhere down the line. And I'm down at the bottom of the barrel, and it feels like I'm blind in the darkness, like I'm lost in a shadow. I can't seem to change things, and I'm so tired of trying and waking up to this reverence. When I open my eyes and I'm losing my
and what's left of my mind. It's like just one more failure might put me out the end. I used to recognize his face. Sitting there really hearted and broken. Looks like he's pretty far from grace. Yeah, his teeth are turning yellow. His skin is cracking dry. And hope keeps on failing him time after time. And he's drunk and frustrated, but he's too tired to cry. Staring back from the mirror through them cold bloodshot eyes. And he's down at the bottom of the barrel. I can't seem to change things, and I'm so tired of trying. And waking up to this red race, when I open my eyes and I'm losing my faith, and what's left of my mind, it's like just one more failure might put me out the end of the line.
Catch Mad Tracks, we have the song Time Slips Away by Carson Hall. Give it a listen. Don't let the time slip away. It's only going to take 5 minutes. Here we go.
Many seals are left unbroken. Many doors are left unopened in my life. Well, I felt the change. One or two few days of wandering, one too many nights upon a long time. Get short and fake. It's no better to watch the hands of time fly.
than to turn away. There's no one of these I'm left from my side. Time slips away, and I've felt the change. Cause I'm just one of 2 years and a couple of roads. I'm turning around, time gets you down, it'll be okay. And I'm not saying it's easy, but you better come clean before the clock runs out. A little more sand falls every day. Time slips away. Many paths I failed to walk, and many times I failed to talk on my turn. It'll come around. One or two few words I've spoken, I'd rather leave the silence unbroken with my heart beating in its place. I still drive the same roads back home. Can't stand the change. There's no telling the last time friends will call out. Time slips away, and I've felt the change. Cause I'm just one or 2 years and a couple of roads. I'm turning around, time gets you down, it'll be okay. I'm not saying it's easy, but you better come clean before the clock runs out. A little more sand falls every day. Time slips away. Time slips away. Time slips away.
Welcome to this week's Indie Radar. I love anything music industry related, obviously, because I do my Indie Radar, but I love discovering new apps and new things, and I love sharing all this stuff with our audience as well as independent artists. There's an independent artist in our audience. There is a new app. It's actually been in development for 2 years. It's called Connect. I hope I'm saying it right. I'm going to spell it Connyct. This app is a challenger to TikTok because it is a short video startup company. It's targeting U.S. college students right now only. You need to have an .edu email address to access this Connect app. And right now they are inviting college students in the United States to apply to use this app before their official launch. We don't have an official launch date yet, but challenger to TikTok. And basically what the company is stating is that they're building a community. And what they mean by that is they built this app so that it's an app built around a video-based event center, which is very cool, very great idea. And it's designed for discovering and promoting local events and activities.
Nice.
So think of like TikTok on that huge scale and building a community, because that seems to be the key to the algorithm of everything right now, right? You want to build a community. It's not about so much getting, 1,000 new followers by tomorrow. Of course you want that. But it's building that community, because once you build that community, you're creating engagement and you're staying on the app. So this app is challenging TikTok, not just random, all kinds of different short form videos, but they want college students' real life to reflect on the app.
That's cool.
Going to be circa. So I thought that was
something new.
So if you're a college student and you've got a band,
there you go.
Check this out.
There
go to connect.com, Connyct.com. If you're a student and you have a .edu email, reach out to them, apply to use the app. And this is going to be a great tool to promote. It's another way to promote your
show. Another great tip right here on Indie Radar. Thank you, Bo.
You're welcome.
I'd like to remind you that The Balcony Show is proudly produced right here at Keiko Studios in Penn Argyle, Pennsylvania. Check them out for all your musical production needs. That's KeikoStudios.com.
It's time for the Spotlight Portal.
portion of our show where we showcase new singles from returning guests. And your host is Donna freaking Gallucci.
But it's actually not Donna freaking Gallucci.
What happened to her? What happened to her?
He's back. He's been abducted by aliens, and now they've transformed Donna into Mike Roy of
the
Secret
People. They do all kinds
of
things up there.
Yeah. This is the most masculine Donna has ever been.
This is Donna.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
I'll tell you what.
Oh, my God. That's great.
Today on the Spotlight, we have an amazing, amazing band with an amazing song. And so we are talking about the band, the Gulfstream Riders. And the song is so amazing. You guys are going to love it.
Brand new.
That's right. Brand spanking new. So we got to unwrap this one here on the show. And this song's called Midnight Rays. And so please sit back and turn it up.
Headed north once again, singing right and see old friends. Lord set a flower upon my hair. Sit and watch the light come through the trees. Smile at all the noise in me. Listen to the summer wind and stare. Ooh, can you feel that? Soaking up them midnight rays. Ooh, it'll hear ya. Soaking up them midnight rays. Soaking up them midnight rays, baby. Midnight rays. Midnight rays, baby. Midnight rays. Break from all that us or them, up to our knees in original sin. My beautiful but very broken nation. I'm all about the golden time of year. Like the way we do it up here, where common sense is in cooperation.
Everybody, thanks for sticking with us and sharing some music with us. And
good show.
Yeah. Thank you, Ryan, for being a part of the show.
Yes,
great
good
guy.
Dude. Yep.
I can't wait to see what music is coming down the line with them because mm-hmm. they're just incredible. And again, if you have the opportunity to see them live, for sure. Tonight, we're going to end things with the song Lonesome by David Nudo Band. I got to remind you, the Reverb Nation. Reverb Nation campaign is kicked in, so if you'd like to get on the show, that's the best way to do it, because that's just the best way to do it. Mm-hmm. So check out Reverb Nation for all your submissions. Anyways, Got anything else, Mad Cat?
Yeah, I just want to shout out one more time to Peanut the Squirrel.
That's right.
And mind your business. If other people are enjoying it and it's not hurting nobody, mind your damn business.
Aww.
Because if you ain't minding your business, you won't be minding mine.
Oh.
That's what's up.
That's what's
all right,
up.
That's another song.
Final
lyric.
Final word right here. But remember, we are your number one source for independent music. Goodbye, everybody, from the Balcony Show. We will catch you next week.
Peace.
If I could write you a song to right my wrong, I'd write a happy ending. Truth be told, I'm growing cold. I keep ending up pretending. In a roundabout way, I start my day loving you. When the day is through, the only truth is there's no love in you. There's no love in you. I've been falling way behind while you were waiting for a light to shine. With these shadows on my heart, my love is hiding in the dark from you. I know you're your heart, you fell apart, and that was never my intention. You've been used and a little abused. I wish you'd mention.